Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to find length of a string in four different ways. So the first approach is we can use a looping statement for loop. And the second approach is we use a while loop and slicing approach. And the third approach is using length method. And fourth approach is by using join and count functions. Now we'll see one by one. So first let us start with the using for loop. Now let me open my PyCharm. And here I'll just creating a new Python file. I will name it as length of a string. Length of a string. And let's take a Python file. So this is my first approach. So let me just take some input and output. So the approach one is I need to use a for loop statement. For that, what I can do is I'll define one string variable, let's say str, and I'll just define welcome. So this is my string. So to find length of a string, I'll just create one more variable, count variable. I'll name it as zero. Let me just take a counter. And initially the counter is zero. So now I'll write a loop statement like this for I in str colon. And here I'll just increase the counter variable. Let's say counter equal to counter plus one. And after completion of this loop, what happens is initially the counter value is zero. And I in str. So in str, there are multiple characters that are there. So in every character will be stored into I. So once you get one character, I'm incrementing the counter value. Again, get another character into I, again incrementing will be done. So this loop will repeat till the last character inside the string. So as soon as all characters are done, so then the counter will stop here. And after come out from this looping statement, the counter is having the number which is representing number of characters in a string. That is exactly length of a string. Now here I'll just print counter. Just print counter. So that is exactly equal to number of characters in a string or length of a string. Now let us run this code and it will give you 7. Right, so this will give you 7. This is the first approach. You can find the length of a string by using for loop. Now I'll show you another approach where I can use while loop along with the slicing technique. This is another approach. Let me comment the first approach. The method two is using while loop and a slicing technique. So here again, I'm just defining my string variable, which is welcome. Also, I'm just taking a counter value, which is zero. Now here I'll write a while loop statement. It'll say while str, here I'm going to use a slicing technique. So in the bracket, I'll say counter colon, and second parameter, I'm not saying anything, empty. So basically, this is a slicing operator. Slicing means a starting point and the end point. So two values we need to pass. For starting point, I'm passing, but the second ending point, I'm not passing here. So inside this, I'll increment the counter value. Let's say counter equal to counter plus one. And after coming out from this looping statement, again, I'm print the counter value. So length of a string, that is representing the length of a string. Now we'll see how it is going to work. So here I'm using slicing operator, right? So initially count equal to zero. So when I see here from zero to, I'm not specifying anything here. So it will take the till the last character. So let us say the how many characters are there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if I count from one to zero, if you count from zero, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are there. So it will take 6. So 0 to 6. Initially count equal to 0. So 0 colon 6. And then it will increase the counter. After increasing the counter 1, again it will go up. Now the counter value becomes 1. So from 1 to 6. So now one character, first character is eliminated. Now rest of them will be there. Right? And then again 1 colon 6. So again there is a true. So there is a value in the string. Now again, increase the counter. Now counter value becomes 2 now. Now again, it will go up. Now counter value becomes a 2 now. Again, it will go up. Again, counter value 3, then 4, then 5, and then 6. As soon as a counter value becomes 6, both are equal. So there is a last character will be represented. So after that, it will exit from this looping statement. Then counter variable contains a counter. That is exactly length of a string. So how many times this loop will repeat depends upon the number of characters. And in each and every iteration, I am eliminating one character by incrementing the count variable here, right? Now let us execute and then it will give you length of a string. Okay, so this is one approach using while loop along with the slicing option. Now there is another method. We have a direct option, that is built-in method, length method we can use, that is length method, len. So by using this method, we can directly find the length of a string. This is a straightforward, it's very simple. Let me just comment this and again define this variable and simply say str.len. len.str. So this is the way we have to specify, and then print len of str. So this will also give you length of a string. This is a straightforward using built-in function. Now when I run this code, it gives you 7. This is a length of a string. And there is one more approach. We have use join and count methods. So there's another approach. Let me just comment these two. So the fourth approach is using join and count. There are two techniques we have to use. So let me show you how we can use join and count techniques. So here I'll again defining the string str equal to welcome. So here what I can do is I'll just take some random string. So let's say some temporary string, let's say random str. Let me just say something called x, something, anything, any random string you can just take. Now here what I can do is I'll just write one method called join. So let me just say random str, right? So this random str and put that into brackets, random str dot random str dot join, random str dot join of str. So what this expression will return? So random str means this one x, join dot join str. So str contains a welcome. So what exactly this will return is, let me just print it. So when I run this code, this will give you, this is an output. So what exactly this output is? So the x is a random string, which is basically inserting in after every character in his actual string. So here once and here one more time, like third time, fourth time, fifth time, six times, totally six times this x is inserted after every character. So this is the final string. WX, EX, LX, CX, OX, MX. Totally how many times X inserted? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. Because we have, depends upon the number of characters. Okay. So after inserting this, what I will do is, I'll just slightly change the same expression. And I'll just use one more method called count. Count of, again, I'll specify the random str. So what this will give you is, so we have just added all the random character after every character in a string, right? So once you will get this one, so this will return this one. Inside this, how many X are there? I'm just counting by using count method. So when I run this code, it will give you 6 as an output. So it is basically counted how many number of X inserted inside this particular string. Now, if you just add plus 1, that is exactly equal to length of a string. Now again, I'm writing the same statement here, and after counting this, just add plus 1, and that's it. So it will give you the 7. This is actually length of a string. This is a length of a string. This is another technique, and you can also change some string, like say welcome to Python. I'm just adding spaces also. Space is also considered as a count. Now when I run this, it will give you exactly 17 characters. And here X is added after every character. Okay. So basically what you have done here is, I'm just added some temporary string after every character in a string by using join method. After that, I have counted how many times this character is inserted in the main string. And then I'm adding plus 1 to the existing value. So that will give you length of a string. So this is the approach we can use by using join and count methods. So the first approach using looping statement, which is for loop. The second approach, we use while loop along with the slicing technique. And third approach, we use length method, which is straightforward, and using join and count methods. Okay. So this is how we can find length of a string in 4 different ways. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.